I'm Randy.
And I'm Keegan.
And this is your
PATS TV. Tell them that it's over. Then bring it on over. Stringing them along any longer, girl, is just wasting precious time.
Beauty Walk tickets will be on sale next Wednesday and Thursday for $10. Buy your tickets now. Mr. Jones is doing some one-act plays November 3rd through 5th.
Margot spoke with the Interact Club about the Halloween buckets for the children at Rise. Let's check in and see how they're going.
Hey there, Hillcrest. We're here with Taylor Burch to talk about Interact's new volunteer project. Let's see what it is.
Okay. Hi, Hillcrest. These are Halloween buckets for the kids at the Rise School, and they are just a little bit of Halloween spirit and lots of toys and goodies that they're really going to appreciate over there.
Oh, that's cool. So what is Rise?
Rise is a school on the university campus, and it's a preschool, and it's for kids with special disabilities and for kids without special disabilities, and they put them all together in a classroom, and it helps promote leadership in our young children.
Well, that's awesome, man. That's a great project for the kids. I know they'll love it. Back to you, Hillcrest.
Thanks, Michael. I think that's a great project for the children at Rise. Some of Hillcrest's band has been nominated to be in the UAH Honor Band. Ryan is here with some of the students now. Let's see what they have to say.
Hey guys, I'm here with the band members who recently accepted to an honor band at the University of Alabama in Huntsville. What exactly is UAH Honor Band about?
A UAH Honor Band is an honor band hosted by the University of Alabama, Huntsville. And it's on November 14th and 15th, hosted by the Randolph School in Huntsville. And it's under the direction of Gary Green, who is the former band director at University of Miami. And he's one of the greatest conductors of our time, so it's going to be really good for the students who got accepted to be under his leadership and really able to observe and soak in all of the information that he gives to us throughout that entire weekend.
I was actually nominated by Mr. Hargrave, our band director, and I got an email from UAH Honor Band telling me I was nominated and if I wanted to do it to finish the application process.
What exactly does it take to be in the UAH Honor Band?
It takes musicality, practice, and you got to have a passion for music in general. So,
thank you. And back to you.
Congratulations, guys. That's a great honor.
Students and administrators are finding a way to make our courtyard space a better place for learning. PATS TV spoke to them to see what they had to say.
As we roll down this unfamiliar road, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
While an outdoor classroom may not seem like much to many people, to Hillcrest students, it's a dream. It would be motivating to be able to take our learning outside the classroom. We have such a great space to use, but the overgrowth of weed and sunken concrete pose safety hazards to the student body. The faculty and staff are even more excited about getting support for the project. I'm here with one of our administrators now, Ms. Morrow. So, Ms. Morrow, do you think the students would enjoy being outside?
I do. I mean, we're out here right now, and it's much more enjoyable than being in a building. So I do think that the students would really enjoy coming outside and being with their teacher and being able to have their voices heard in this wonderful setting called a courtyard. I think anytime you can take learning and make it more robust in an environment, I think that really does enhance the attention span of students. So I can just see all of the content areas, the math and the science, the social studies, the English and the foreign language teachers coming outside and demonstrating a lesson, having the students participate. And with that in mind, both teaching and learning will be enhanced, and I think that it will be an invaluable lesson. I fully expect students to go home in the afternoon and to tell their parents how exciting that particular novel came to be, how the mathematics that they did as they're looking at certain equations, the science that's involved, and of course all of the social studies and the foreign language too. I think that this will make a very special lesson.
Well, you know, here at Hillcrest, our beauty in our courtyard is abundant. I mean, it's just hidden by all the broken and the dead. I feel like if the students could come out there and make it their own, then they will be able. They would want to come here. They will want to learn, and then that way they will want to succeed.
In light of that thought, the students here at Hillcrest are already planning and designing what they want their courtyard to look like.
About our art class,
for electives like Spanish class, they can come.
I think potential here at Hillcrest is endless, and I think if we're able to expand our classrooms outside, it would really benefit our students. Especially in our core classes, if we're able to take our assignments outside, even just to sit in the beautiful fresh air, like we would be able to do much better and have a lot more fun with our assignments. Not only would it benefit our core classes, but I think it would benefit our fine arts classes as well. Being able to take inspiration from outside in the courtyard would help our art classes a lot. And I think even being able to help in the building process would benefit our students, being able to take a part in the building process of the school that we go into every day.
Hey Hillcrest, we're in the early stages of redesigning our courtyard here, and we are looking for ideas and plans from teachers and students as to how this might happen. But we want to encompass all the different academic classes, and we want to encompass all the different arts in the reconstruction of this beautiful space. Listen to ideas that you might have, just you can bring them by to me, and we'll look at those. My art classes are hoping to do some paintings that would last, you know, outdoor types paintings for different art pieces or different academic classes, maybe even creating some clay tiles that we can form to put against different walls or steps and things of that sort. So we hope that students and teachers from all the different educational disciplines will take part in this construction, because I think it's a beautiful place that we all could use one day.
This dream is not going to become a reality without your help, Hillcrest. Submit your ideas to your teachers. Let your parents know that we welcome their help. And most of all, stay positive and know that together we can make this happen.
Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
That's a great idea, Hillcrest. We're looking forward to the end of the project.
October's National Bully Prevention Month. PATS TV has prepared a skit for you.
Don't laugh at me. Don't call me names. Don't get your pleasure from my pain. In God's eyes, we're all the same. Someday we'll all have perfect wings. Don't laugh at me.
Remember who you are, Patriots. Bullying is not the way to go. Now, let's talk to Coach Dillon and Coach Bryant about the injuries from last Friday. Let's see how that affected our team. Coach Dillon, the offensive line coach, to talk about last week's game against Bryant Stampede. So, Coach, how did the injuries in the second half affect the way that the team played?
We had a couple guys hurt throughout the game, whether they got hurt going into the game or during the game. It affected us. We weren't able to do some of the things that we normally do. But a sign of a good team is to overcome those things and still become productive on offense, and I think we did a good job of that in the second half.
Yes, sir. Did you expect Bryant to come out the way that they came out and play?
I actually did. They, they're not the Bryant that they have been the past couple of years. They came into the game with a shot to make the playoffs, considering if they beat us and McAdory next week. So they had a lot to play for still. And, they came in fired up, and I think we answered the call. Bottom line is getting the W, and that's what we did.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Coach.
You're welcome.
Hey, you guys. We're here with defensive coach, Coach Bryant, to talk about last week's game also. Did you expect the Bryant Stampede to come out the way that they came out?
Every team, you expect them to give them the best. The thing that surprised us a little bit was their running back. I thought the running back had a great game. He, on film, he didn't look as fast as he was, but once he got, to that second level, he was able to explode on us. And he was a little elusive to tackle. Yeah, he was a good ball player, and that surprised us.
Yes, sir. Coach, did you think that the injuries that the defense had affected the way the defense played?
It should never affect you. Next man should be ready to play. You know, excuses are very poor. You know, I just think all excuses stink. You shouldn't make an excuse for anything. You should overcome adversity. And when you have adversity, the next man should be able to step up and make the play. The thing I think we came out a little flat defensively, thinking that we were better than they were. Mm-hmm. And when you assume that your team that you're playing is better than you are, bad things happen. You got to always play your game, not the other team's game.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Coach.
You are welcome.
All righty.
Back it.
Thanks, Darius. We look forward to seeing you guys crush Brookwood tonight. Go Pats. Pats TV continues its search for talent. Jaden caught up with Josh Childs. Let's see what talent he has for us. If you want to say no, what do you mean?
Hey, we're here with Josh Giles for Pat's Got Talent. So, Josh, when did you start singing?
Well, when I was 2 years old, I was riding in the car with my mom, and she was playing a gospel song on the radio. And when the highest part of the song came, I hit all the notes perfectly, and my mom was like, "Whoa!" And I was like, "Yeah, that was me." And then ever since then, I've been singing at schools and at churches and things like that.
So, do you plan on taking this further in life?
Yes, I do. I do plan on pursuing a career being a singer-songwriter.
Okay, let's see what he has.
I'll be singing Bound to You by Christina Aguilera. I am bound to you. I am bound to. Suddenly the moment's here. I embrace my fears. All that I have been carrying all these years. Do I risk it all? Come this far just to fall. 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 I can trust him, babe. I believe in love. I am terrified to love for the first time. Can't you see I'm bound in chains? I finally found my way. I am bound to you. I am bound to you. Thank you.
Good job, Josh. I wish I could sing like that.
Thank you. I'm Randy.
And I'm Keegan.
And that was your
PATS TV.